Hey, Mike. So what did Dearness and the kickoff return team do so well Sunday?
Well, I think we had the right idea, the right scheme against those guys. They're very aggressive, and we took advantage of their aggressiveness. I thought we blocked it up very well. Both those returns were blocked well. The first one, they took the backside safety or the return side safety, as we look at it, and they brought them over a little bit further than they normally would have, and that really helped to our advantage. And I thought that was a very well blocked return. The guys did a good job, and Dearness ran hard and got out to the 45, and that got the momentum going, got the sideline going, and we went down and made it 7-3. So I thought that was a huge play for us. And the second one, you know, we've all been on, including his teammates, have been on Dearness all week long. He should have kept that outside, and it was another very well blocked play. We talk about hitting the seam, hitting the sideline. If he hits the sideline, he might get another 15 yards. So, and our offense did a great job and took advantage of that good field position, went down and kicked a field goal. So there were two big plays for us.
Thanks, Scott. Jeff Shadell, you have our next question.
Hey, Mike, could you just give us a good summary of the Titans' special teams, especially their return game?
So their kickoff returner, 13 Batson, he's very, very quick. He's one of those guys that if you're out of control at the point of attack, and I've been telling our guys all week, if you're out of control at the point of attack, he's going to make you miss, pure and simple. And, number 14, Randall's done a nice job as a kickoff returner earlier in the year and as their punt returner. He's averaging over 9 yards a return. He had a 40-yarder earlier in the year. He's another guy that's going to try to stretch the field on us and try to get to the outside. We've got to do a great job of leveraging those guys. And, you know, overall, I know their coach, he's a really good young coach, Craig Aukerman. Brett Kern's been a fantastic, fantastic directional punter for years and years, in the Pro Bowl a couple times, I believe. Steven Guskowski settled down earlier in the year. He had some misses and had a couple blocked, and he settled down and done a nice job. He's made 4 out of 5 at the end of the game where they either needed to tie or win. So, I mean, and they play hard. I mean, they got guys that they take on their personality, their head coach, and he was a tough guy. He was a tough guy when he played. He's a tough guy as a coach, and that kind of trickles down to all three of the phases, OD and special teams. So, you know, that's the thing, the message I'm bringing to our guys, that we got to match it or surpass their intensity, and we got to get after them.
Thank you, Jeff. Dan Lobby, you're next.
Hey, Coach. How has Donovan kind of handled getting taken off kick return? And, I mean, it kind of looked on Sunday like he was sort of leading the way on those big returns blocking. So how has he handled that?
Like a pro. He's an amazing young man. I'm proud of him. That's hard for a young player who came in as a, you know, we drafted him to be a returner. And when JoJo went down, he came and took over both. And I think Dearness provided a little bit of juice for us on kickoff return last week. And that was very evident. And Donovan was a big part of that. He did a great job lead blocking. He blew up the kicker on the one, and it was a great block. Allowed us to get another 10, 12 yards. And then the second one, he did a nice job as well. And we just got to take advantage of that blocking, like I said earlier, get outside and get another 10, 15 yards. But he's a pro. He's a backup gunner. And we can use him as a one or a two on kickoff if we need him to. He's done a great job on offense because he knows all three spots. You talked to Coach O'Shea about how well the young man knows the offense at such a young age. So he's been a very valuable part of our football team. I'm glad we have him.
Thanks.
Thank you, Dan. Tom Withers, you're up.
Thank you, Rob. Thanks, Mike. Hey, Mike, it seems so rare that you see a long kickoff or punt return anymore. I mean, it seems like in the old days, you know, you'd see one much more often than you do now. What would be the reason for that? Is it better schemes on coverage? Do you have better athletes? What do you think leads to some of that?
I think one of the reasons on kickoff is the rule change. You know, you only have three guys deep. So if these guys get by those front eight, you know, the eight guys that are in setup zone, they have more of an opportunity to make plays. And you know, return teams are doing a good job of trying to scheme and do some different things to take away that aggressiveness. Like we had some issues earlier in the year. I think we're doing a better job lately. We got to keep doing that to help our defensive field position. But I think part of it's the rule changes on kickoff and kickoff return. Some of these punters, like you look at the punter we're going against, Brett Kern, it's a phenomenal directional punter. And even though he doesn't always get great hang time, if you put a 52-yard punt that's 4-4 hang time outside the numbers from the sideline, if you got a good gunner on that side, I mean, even if you vice him up and he does a nice job getting down there, you're not going to get very far. So I think In our stadium, it's tougher for punters and kickers to do some of that stuff, but because of the wind and weather that we've had this year. But I think that's part of it. The punting and the directional punting and the kickoff return type of rules have limited a little bit. Plus, people are kicking a lot of touchbacks too. They don't want to deal with that. Sometimes I was very stubborn. Obviously, early in the year, you guys saw that. We talked about that. We were challenging teams early and kind of backfired on us a little bit. And we've settled down and kick touchbacks when we need to, and our guys are covering a lot better too. So I'm excited about the last 5 weeks and continue improving in all areas.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Tony Grossi has our next question.
All right. Mike, I know what you said about Tennessee, but two of their three losses were the direct result of special teams breakdowns. I know Kern was out for the one game where they had a disaster against the Colts. Do you believe there are some vulnerabilities there, or have they patched those up?
I think losing Brett Kern hurt them a lot, and they had two different punters come in there and try to shore it up. And I know the one punter they had in, they had a punt blocked. It wasn't his fault on the block, but he had shanked one for, 15, 20 yards the one before. Yeah. I think anytime you lose a guy like Brett Kern, it really hurts their punt team and their field goal team too. And they had some snapping issues earlier, and they've replaced a snapper as well. So I think they've shored it up. Again, I guess clearly I think they're well coached. And I want to say, Tony, I'm very surprised you're asking such questions. You only let go deep.
Oh, I'm sorry. I missed that. It went foggy.
I was messing with you, Tony, because you never ask special teams questions. I think you've asked maybe one or two all year. I'm just messing with you, you don't like special teams.
It's a scheduling conflict, but today I avoided.
Oh, of course. Of course. It is. I get it. You don't miss any O&D stuff, though. I'm, like I said, I'm only kidding.
Thanks for noticing.
No, I
know. Thanks, Tony. Nate Ulrich, you're up.
Hey, Mike. I wanted to ask you about the big picture, where the team is at right now and just how far it's come since, I know every year is different, but you guys played the Titans last season in the opener. What kind of, big picture mindset do you have about where you guys are now?
I think this team handles itself very well without looking at too far ahead, Last year, I think, coming into the season, everybody was talking playoffs and Super Bowl and all that stuff. And I don't think you can do that. I don't think you can do that any year, no matter how much talent you have on your team. I think from our head coach on down to everybody, this coaching staff, the players, we've approached each week differently. How do we win this game? How do we win this week? And, what do we need to do offensively, defensively, and on special teams to beat the Tennessee Titans, for example? And that's been our main focus. And I think when you do it that way and you just go one week at a time and you approach it that way, you have much more chance of success. You don't get caught up in too much of the outside distractions and everybody telling you, oh, you're 8-3, you're going to playoffs. Well, that's not necessarily the case. What we have to do is we have to win this week, and it's going to put us one game closer to that playoff, to the playoff situation. So I think, again, we've done a good job of going week by week by week, and I think that's the only way to handle that.
Hey, so when you're talking about that focus that's crucial, do you think that's a result of getting burned last year? Like they got, the players coming back maybe learned from that? Or is it Kevin Stefanski getting everybody locked in, or is it a combination?
I don't know if a lot of the guys weren't here last year, or if they were, they weren't playing as much on offense, defense, or even special teams. I think this is a brand new team, and our personnel guys have done a nice job of bringing in guys that are laser focused, that have an understanding how important every situation is, every different situation, every down and distance on offense and defense, every kicking, punting, field goal situation for special teams. So I do think that starts with the leadership at the top with Kevin, and it has trickled down to the staff. And, I know him. I've known him a long time. And that's how we were both brought up in this business. And that's how, I've learned it from Tom Coughlin to Jim Tressel to other guys that I work for as head coaches. So I've learned a lot over the years how important that focus is week by week by week, and you can't get caught up in all the other stuff. And I know the fans love that, and as a fan, I would have loved that. And I'm a big Cleveland Indian fan. I do the same thing as a baseball fan. But I think when you're a coach or you're a player, you have to approach it one day at a time, one game at a time.
Thank you, Nate. Scott Petrick, back to you.
Hey, Mike, I had another thing about Donovan I wanted to ask you. I think at the beginning of the year you talked about how his body was kind of meant for kickoff return, but he didn't have a lot of experience in that area. So is it the lack of experience that you think is kind of I don't know, causing the struggles and the reason you made the switch to De'Ernest, or is it more of a skill set thing?
You know, I think he's still got the great skill set. He's a big, strong guy that can run. I think with him, we just needed a change for that return unit. And again, like I said, I put him on at halfback as more of a blocker. Plus, if they do kick it short, he's back there and he can handle those shorter type of kicks because he's a good ball security guy. And he's handled it like a pro. I think with experience, he will get better. And again, he doesn't have a lot of kickoff return experience, but not to make excuses for him. We should be better as a unit with him back there. It's not always his fault. We didn't always block it well for him. And people have schemed us nice at times and done a good job of kicking us into the corners and done some different things. So again, we needed a spark. And I think De'Ernest provided that spark on Sunday. And I hope that keeps going.